Hi guys, Nick Jennison for Guitar Interactive Magazine, and on the test bench today we're having a look at the latest two models in Mooer's line of micro preamp pedals. Case you missed it, the micro preamps are a series of tiny format, kind of like amp in a box type pedals, but they're designed to connect to your amp's effects return or directly to a mixing desk, which you can use for recording or going straight to front of house, and they are absolutely tiny. Now, you probably know Mooer as the originators of the tiny pedal format, at least they are to my mind, and these wee diddy little pedals kind of follow in that tradition. And we're looking at numbers 19 and 20, which should tell you exactly how many models there are in this series. There are all sorts of amps covered, from high gain screaming metal monsters through to boutique clean crystalline jobs, you name it, it's all in there. And the ones we're looking at today are, well, let's get this right, we have the UK Gold PLX, which is number 19, I'll explain what these are in a moment, and the BLUENO, it's B-L-U-E-N-O, it's like a Bruno amp, which we'll come to in a moment. So number 19 is essentially a very specific 50 watt plexi from 1967, I'll get that date right, and it's actually sampled from an amp from Tracy Gunn's personal collection. Tracy Gunn's is a Mooer artist, so they've had access to his amp vault, if you want to call it that, and this is perhaps his favorite plexi, which is maybe why it's purple, and that's been sampled for this pedal. The number 20, the BLUENO, is a Bruno Underground 30, which is a fabulous fat sounding boutique style amplifier. Let's start by discussing how these pedals work, and then we'll explain some tones. So I'm going to demonstrate this on the UK Gold PLX, but the operation is the same on both pedals and all the pedals in this preamp series. We have essentially an on-off switch, and this button down here acts as a channel switch, and the blue channel in this instance is a clean channel, and the red channel is a distortion channel. Now, interestingly enough, the positions of the five rotary controls are remembered by the channel that you you select. So if, for example, you run the gain very high on the clean channel and the volume low, when you switch to the distortion channel, if you decide to set them both at 12 o'clock, like we did in the intro jam, and then go back to the clean channel, it will remember where you set those knobs from the last time you had them on, which is very interesting. It also remembers that when you power cycle it too. So it's a bit like having two presets. If you want to, you can engage and disengage the effect with the foot switch, or if you press and hold the foot switch, the effect becomes on all of the time, and you can switch between the two channels with the foot switch. As if that wasn't enough, there's also a built-in speaker sim, which you can get by pressing and holding this button. And you'll notice the light is now flashing to let you know that the speaker simulation is on. But because we're running into the effects return of our Laney GH30R, we're gonna turn that off for now, although we will have a listen in just a moment. As previously mentioned, the operation is exactly the same for both pedals. So we'll turn that off, we can turn that on. There's the channel switching, press and hold. There's the channel switching, press and hold, and now the cab sim is on. But we'll turn that off for now. So let's begin by looking at some clean tones, and we're going to compare the two pedals we have here. We're going to fire up a loop, and I'm just going to play with some of the controls, and we'll see how they sound. Thank you. there's quite a big difference between the clean voices of these two preamps. As you'd expect, they are based on very different amplifiers after all. There's a lot more bite and distortion available, if you want to call it that, in the number 20 BLUENO. Still not sure how to pronounce that, but I'll try my best. Also, there's kind of a very fat, low mid-range presence in this number 20 model, whereas number 19 is a little leaner, as you'd expect from a Plexi, but there is a lot of low-end cabinet bump available. And if you dial the gain control back, it can actually get very sparkly, which is also true of number 20. But there you go, lots of lovely clean voices on the go. Let's try the same thing, but this time with the distortion channels on our two preamps. Once again, we'll fire up a little loop and we'll hear how they sound. So as you can hear, the distortion voices are quite different, but they both have a wonderful fat vocal mid-range quality. Although the purple UK Gold PLX is a lot more aggressive with a much more pronounced bark, whereas the BLUENO is perhaps fatter and more singing maybe. Although there is a lot more gain on tap on the little purple fella down there, perhaps more than I would expect to see on a traditional Plexi amp, which leads me to believe that perhaps it was modeled on a modded Plexi. It's definitely got that kind of vibe about it. Either way, they're both fantastic for big singing, soaring lead tones and heavy riffing alike, if that's your sort of thing. If you're more of a rock guy, you might be better suited with the purple fella. More into your blues and fusion, you might be better with the BLUENO. Anyway, one of the little tests I'd like to perform is we're going to compare the onboard speaker sim, which I will engage by pressing and holding this button, and you can see the LED is flashing, which means the onboard speaker simulation is active. We're going to compare that sound to the pedal going through Mooer's radar cab sim, and that's an IR loader, and it's a little more sophisticated than the onboard filter-based speaker sims on the pedals. I'm gonna suggest that we'll probably get better results with the IR loader, however, this little feature might just save your bacon if your amp happens to go down at a gig and you've got one of these on your board. It's a very, very handy feature to have. So you'll know which is going on, because if the LED is flashing, then the onboard speaker sim will be active. When we press and hold and it goes static, that means the onboard speaker sim has been disabled, and we'll very quickly switch over to our radar, which is just out of shot over here. There will be a moment of fizzy death as we go between the two, but that is just the nature of live performance. Anyway, let's fire ourselves up that same loop from before. This time we're going to be running DI, and we'll hear how that sounds. We'll be right back. So while the results are marginally better with the Radar IR loader, I actually don't think the internal speaker simulations on these two pedals sound that bad at all. In fact, I think they sound pretty great. It really will help you out in a pinch if, for example, your amp goes down at a gig, or maybe you are unable to travel with your amp. Perhaps you're doing a fly date, or you're just going to a jam night, or just going around to a friend's house, so you just want to get some stuff recorded very, very quickly. Of course, they do just sound kind of different to each other, but you'd expect that because the two different preamps are going to have different cabs that are optimized for their respective voices. So anyway, I've got to say, I'm pretty impressed with these two pedals. I've been impressed with every model in Mooer's little line of preamps thus far, and these two are no exception. They're going to suit very different players. I feel as though the purple UK Gold PLX is definitely for the rockers out there, whereas the BLUENO is going to be more for your sort of blues fusion types. Both great sounding though, really, really nice for lead stuff, nice for cleans, good for riffing, you name it, all sorts of good stuff. Anyway, guys, my name is Nick Jennison for Guitar Interactive Magazine. This has been number 19 and 20 in Mooer's series of micro preamp pedals, and I'll see you next time.